السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالًا كثيرًا ونساءً واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبًا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما وبعد عباد الله فلنحمد الله تعالى على أن بلغنا شهر رمضان فالحمد لله على بلوغ شهر رمضان هذا شهر رمضان شهر الجود والكرم والقرآن والإحسان وسوف أركز إن شاء الله تعالى في خطبة اليوم على بعض مظاهر الجود في رمضان مقسما للخطبة إلى قسمين في القسم الأول بالحديث عن كرم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وجوده وإحسانه في مرحلة ما قبل البعثة وما بعدها ثم في الخطبة الثانية إن شاء الله تعالى ثم في الخطبة الثانية إن شاء الله تعالى عن بعض مظاهر الجود كما ذكرها ابن القيم وسأضيف إليها بعض الأشياء حتى يستطيع كل منا فعلها تذكيرا بذلك لماذا أتكلم عن جود رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن قدوتنا ومثالنا وأسوتنا هو حبيبنا صلى الله عليه وسلم كما قال جل من قائل في سورة الأحزاب لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا. The respected brothers and sisters and elders, we should thank Allah سبحانه وتعالى for reaching the month of Ramadan and alhamdulillah for reaching the month of Ramadan. Ramadan is a month of Quran. is a month of charity and generosity. And today, inshallah, I will focus on generosity in Ramadan by dividing this khutbah into sections. The first one, I will speak about the generosity of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Jahiliyyah, pre-Islam era, and after Islam, to see and to follow his own model, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us in Surah 33, verse 21. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ. Verily, in the Messenger of Allah, you have a good example. For whom? For him who looks and to Allah and the last day and remembers Allah much. The second khutbah, inshallah, the second section of the khutbah, as we have some people who may not be Muslims, so it will be talking about some types and levels of generosity. As mentioned by great scholar Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyyah rahimahullah, I will choose some of them and add some others to them, so we will have plenty of options in this month. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to be the most generous. No wonder, because he's Allah's messenger. And Allah, as he said, Allahu a'lamu haythu yaj'alu risalatihi qira'atan. Allah knows where he puts his messages. He raises his prophets, his messengers, in the best way, in the best way that person can imagine. So let's take some examples in his life before Islam. لنأخذ بعض الأمثلة قبل الإسلام على كرم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ونبله. وأحسن من يشهد بذلك. انتبهوا أيها الأزواج. أحسن من يشهد بذلك هو الزوجة، لأنها تعلم حقيقة زوجها وتعلم طريقة حركاته وذكره وتصرفه. عندما التقى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم جبريل، خاف على نفسه، فأخذته أمنا خديجة رضي الله عنها إلى ابن عمها ورقة بن نوفل، فقالت له بعد ذلك: كلا، عندما قال لها خفت على نفسي، كلا والله لا يخزيك الله أبدا، إنك لتصل الرحم وتحمل الكلة وتقري الضيف وتكسب المعدوم وتعين على نوائب الدهر. وهذه الأشياء الأربع ذكر أو الخمس ذكر العلماء أن من اتصف بها لن يخزيه الله سبحانه وتعالى. So when Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam met with the angel Gabriel for the first time, when he received the revelation, he told his beloved wife, and this is going to be a good testimony. So husbands, please be aware of this. Wives know the status of their husbands. If they describe them as that hadith of the famous hadith, Ummu Zara, 11 women, when they described their husbands, so they said everything about them. So watch out. Khadija radiallahu anha told Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, never by Allah, Allah will never disgrace you. Why? Listen to the following characters. You keep good relations with your kith and kin. Help the poor and the destitute. Serve your guests generously. And assist the deserving calamity afflicted ones. So this is enough to give us some examples heading to Islam, which is the second subject here in this first khutbah. When Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam received the message, he even became more generous. Let's listen to the following hadith, inshallah. وفي الإسلام عباد الله كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أكرم الناس وأجودهم. كيف لا وهو يعلم صدق ما عند الله وهو يعلم أن الخير كله بيد الله وأن الله سبحانه وتعالى يحب المحسنين. روى البخاري ومسلم من حديث أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه أنه قال: كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أحسن الناس وكان أجود الناس وكان أشجع الناس. So Anas رضي الله عنه, and Anas spent 10 years with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and he gave good accounts of his behavior and characters living with him while he was 10 years old until he became 20 years old. He said in one of the hadith, this one, he said the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, peace be upon him, was the best of people, the most generous of people, and most courageous of people. And Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, the uncle of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the cousin rather, he used to say, كَانَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أَجْوَدَ النَّاسِ وَكَانَ أَجْوَدَ أَوْ أَجْوَدُ رِوَايَةً ما يكون في رمضان حين يلقاه جبريل فيدارسه القرآن، فلرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أجود بالخير من الريح المرسلة. Which means Allah's messengers, peace be upon him, was the most generous of all people. And he used to reach the peak of his generosity in the month of Ramadan, which we are in now. When Jibreel, the angel Gabriel, met him, Jibreel, the angel, used to meet him every night of Ramadan to recite, to teach him the Quran and to revise it with him. Allah's messengers, peace be upon him, was the most generous person, even more generous than the strong, uncontrollable wind in readiness and haste to do charitable deeds. Abbas radiallahu anhu, كما في صحيح مسلم, ما سئل رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم على الإسلام شيئا إلا أعطاه. فجاءه رجل فأعطاه غنما بين جبلين, فرجع إلى قومه فقال يا قوم أسلموا فإن محمدا يعطي عطاء من لا يخشى الفاقة أو الفقر, وهما بمعنى واحد. The meaning of that is Musa, the son of Anas radiallahu anhu, reported that on the authority of his father, Anas ibn Malik again. He said, it's never happened that Allah's messengers, peace be upon him, was asked anything for the sake of Islam, and he did not give that. There come to him a person, and he gave him a large flock of sheep and goats. And he went back, that man, to his people and said, my people, embrace Islam for Muhammad, peace be upon him. Give so much charity as if is no fear of want or poverty. Safwan ibn Umayyah was one of the most known enemy of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. On the day of Hunayn, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on that day gave him 300 camels, which is a fortune, a lot of money at that time and still today. So Safwan radiallahu anhu said, wallahi laqad a'tani rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ma a'tani wa innahu la abghadu an-nas ilay فما برح يعطيني حتى إنه لا أحب الناس إلي. So the meaning of that is Allah's messenger gave me 300 camels. He was the most detested person amongst people in my eyes, but he continued giving to me until now. He is the dearest of people to me. The Arab poet says, أحسن إلى الناس تستعبد قلوبهم فطالما استعبد الإنسان إحسانه. Do charity to people so you will win their hearts and mind. Today the missionaries in Africa and other poor countries, they use three sophisticated weapons: free education, free healthcare, and free loans, or giving money for free. If people wants to follow the steps of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and also the steps of all prophets, they should give generously. Now, last point. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam died, his shield was given as a collateral for some food that he took for his family. Allah has given him the fifth, 20% of the income of the state, as in Surah Al-Anfal, Surah 8. وَعَلَمُوا أَنَّمَا غَنِمْتُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَأَنَّ لِلَّهِ خُمُسَهُ وَلِلرَّسُولِ. Yet he dispersed it, he spent it for the sake of Allah, he gave it to the needy. So he did not leave a penny or a dime for his family, like all prophets. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, نَحْنُ مَعَاشِرَ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ لَا نُورَثْ. We the prophets cannot be inherited by our families. مَا تَرَكْنَاهُ صَدَقَةً. Whatever we leave behind will be public fund, charity. That's why his beloved daughter, Fatima رضي الله عنها, and his beloved uncle, Al-Abbas رضي الله عنه, came to Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه when he became the Khalifa after the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, asking for their shares in Badak. He said, no, I cannot give it to you. I heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying that, نَحْنُ مَعَاشِرَ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ إِلَى نُورَثْ مَا تَرَكْنَاهُ صَدَقَةً. So, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he strove all of his life to disseminate the message of Allah, to teach and preach and save people from the hellfire. He was deprived of sleeping. Once he received the revelation, in some narration he told his beloved wife, Khadija, لَقَدْ وَلَّا عَهْدُ النَّوْمِ يَا خَدِيجَةً. The time of sleeping is gone. There is no time to sleep. In a day, he's busy with people, teaching, preaching, and answering their questions, and helping them, and visiting the sick, and visiting the graveyards and leading the prayers and receiving the convoys and emissaries. And at night he's praying most of the night for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So generosity is very important. Generosity is the character of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As we're going to see shortly inshallah, generosity does not mean to spend money. There are a lot of things that we can and should be generous of with before and after money. Ibadallah, sallallahu subhanahu wa ta'ala al-maghfirah wa tubu ilayhi innahu wa ghafur rahim. Please ask Allah forgiveness so He may forgive us. الحمد لله الحنان المنان الحمد لله الذي أعطى وأوسع الحمد لله على كل شيء يحب أن يحمد عليه بكل شيء يحب أن يحمد به الحمد لله على كل نعمة أنعم بها علينا في قديم أو حديث أو خاصة أو عامة له الحمد بالإسلام وله الحمد بالإيمان وله الحمد بالعافية وله الحمد بالمال والأهل والولد وله الحمد على بلوغ شهر رمضان وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد سيد الخلق وأكثرهم سخاء وجودا كان أجود الناس وكان أجود ما يكون في رمضان. The respected brothers and sisters and elders, two nights ago in the Taraweeh, we heard verse 92 of Surah 3. Verse 92 of chapter 3, the family of Imran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in that verse, لَن تَنَالُ الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. By no means shall you attain al-birr, which refers to piety, righteousness, also means the paradise, the reward of Allah, which is a paradise. You will not attain the piety or righteousness unless you spend in Allah's cause of that which you love. And whatever of good you spend, Allah knows it well, very well. You know, sometimes you see the food, the blood banks, or they say all types are welcome. Same in generosity. All types of charity is welcome in this month. Imam Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah, he has a great book called Madarij al-Sadiqin, في منازل إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. 10 categories, 10 levels of generosity. I'm not going to mention all of them because it depends on the situation of the giver and the situation of the recipients. I will mention only a few of them. Number 4 of what he mentioned was to be generous of knowledge. Al-judu bil-ilm, to teach, to preach, to answer the questions. For a physician to answer a question for a patient, a person who doesn't know. For a teacher to teach some things, please move forward, jazakallahu khairan. To give, to be generous of knowledge. We are not speaking about monetary forms of generosity. We'll speak about two categories of it at the end, inshallah ta'ala. So, to be generous in knowledge, to teach people, to preach, to answer their questions, to give advices. An academic advisor to advise a student about where to go. That would be among very important things that people can do. The best healthcare options, the best, you know, treatment that a patient can get, you know, best financial advisors in this life. So best of everything to give people and al-mustashar al-mu'taman. If someone comes to you and asks you to give your own view about something that you know, you should be honest with him. Give him your best knowledge and you should not hide it, inshallah ta'ala. The second one, which is number 6, based on Ibn Qayyim index, al-judu bi'amal al-jawarih, to act with our own limbs and body, the physical strength that Allah has given us, to use it to help people. And the famous hadith of that is that there is a charity due on every organ or every joint. يُصْبِحُ عَلَى كُلِّ سُلَامَ مِنْ أَحَدِكُمْ صَدَقَةٌ وَتَسْبِحَةٌ صَدَقَةٌ وَتَحْمِيدَةٌ صَدَقَةٌ وَتَحْمِلُ الرَّجُلَ عَلَى دَابَّتِهِ صَدَقَةٌ وَتَصْنَعُ لِأَخْرَقَ صَدَقَةٌ وَيَكْفِي مِنْ ذَلِكَ وَيُجْزِئُ مِنْ ذَلِكَ رَكْعَتَانِ يَرْكَعُهُمَا مِنَ الضُّحَى وَالْحَدِيثُ صَحِيحٌ رواه مسلم. The meaning of that, Prophet ﷺ said, when you get up in the morning, charity is due from every one of your joints. There is a charity in every ascription of glory to Allah, saying subhanallah, glory to be Allah. There is a charity in every declaration of His greatness, Allahu Akbar. There is a charity in every utterance of praise of Him, alhamdulillah, praise be to Allah. There is a charity in every declaration that He is the only true God, worthy of worship. La ilaha illallah. There is a charity in enjoying good. There is a charity in forbidding evil. Two rak'ah, two prostrations, two bows, two prostrations for brothers who are not Muslims. Of duha, forenoon prayer is equal to all of this in reward. So to use our own physical strength to help people, our mental capacity to help people, to guide them to the best way is a good charity, and we should not belittle any of the charity as it's going to come, even with a smiling face. Number 7, based on Ibn Qayyim, which is a third here, al-judu bil-arab. So to forgive people who invade our honor, people who criticize us for no reasons, people who slander us, people who defame us, we just leave them for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A famous story of that is Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, his cousin, whom he raised from, you know, zero to hero, Mistah ibn Udada. He was among the people who slandered our beloved mother, the beloved daughter of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, Aisha, and he vowed not to give him a dime. Yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed in Surah 24, وَلَا يَأْتَلِ أُولُو الْفَضْلِ مِنْكُمْ وَالسَّعَةِ أَنْ يُؤْتُوا أُولِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْيَتَامَى وَالْمَسَاكِينَ وَالْمُهَاجِرِينَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. قام أبو بكر رضي الله عنه يزر رداءه ويقول بلى والله بلى والله وزاد. So Allah told us in this verse the meaning, do not let those people whom Allah has given wealth and abundance to have an oath not to give charity to those people. Rather, they should forgive them. Abu Bakr said, yes, I would love that Allah to forgive me. And he increased his giving to him. Look back. He hit him back, but he gave him back something good. And that also is in Surah 3, Surah Ali Imran, verses 133 and 134. وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ وَعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ الذين ينفقون بالسراء والضراء والكاظمين الغيظ والعافين عن الناس والله يحب المحسنين. And hasten to forgiveness from your Lord and garden as wide as the heavens and earth prepared for the righteous. Who are the following 2-3 verses describe them. This verse says, who spends in the cause of Allah during ease and hardship, and who restrain anger at the point here, and who pardon the people, and Allah loves the doers of good, those who do good deeds. Al-judu bil-khuluqi wal-bishri wal-bista. Number 9 for Al-Qayyim, number 4 for this khutbah. So to be generous with our character, with our manner, with our good behavior, and that is the heaviest things on the scale. أَثْقَلُ مَا يُضَعُ فِي الْمِيزَانِ حُسْنُ الْخُلُقِ. وَلَذَلِكَ قَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ لَا تَحْقِرَنَّ مِنَ الْمَعْرُوفِ شَيْئًا وَلَوْ أَنْ تَلْقَى أَخَاكَ بِوَجْهٍ طَلْقٍ. حديث أبو ذر رضي الله عنه. Do not consider any act of goodness as being insignificant, even if it is meeting your brother with a cheerful face. The number 10, based on Ibn Qayyim's index, he said, which is very important, أَجُودُ بِتَرْكِهِمَا فِي أَيْدِ النَّاسِ عَلَيْهِمْ فَلَا يَلْتَفِتُ إِلَيْهِمْ فَلَا يَلْتَفِتُ إِلَيْهِ وَلَا يَسْتَشْرِفُ لَهُ بِقَلْبِهِ وَلَا يَتَعَرَّضُ لَهُ بِحَالِهِ وَلِسَانِهِ. To be generous by not looking at what Allah has given people. Many times we look at what people have another way. We look at the empty part of the cup. We don't look at the full part of the cup. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in 2 verses, Surah 15 and Surah 20, forbade his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from extending his eyes to what he has given other people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so generous, and he's a razzaq, and he divides the rizq, provision among people, and he prefers some of them over some. Usually we look at the monetary aspects of rizq, but health-wise we don't look at it. Education, safety, you know, peace of mind. There are many celebrities, many famous people who cannot sleep, who take their own life, commit suicide. They have everything in this life, have every luxury of this life, yet there is no happiness. There is a vacuum in their hearts. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Surah 15, Al-Hijr, verse 88, لَا تَمُدَّنَّ عَيْنَيْكَ إِلَى مَا مَتَّعْنَا بِهِ أَزْوَاجًا مِّنْهُمْ وَلَا تَحْزَنْ عَلَيْهِمْ وَاخْفِضْ جَنَاحَكَ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Do not extend your eyes toward that by which we have given enjoyment to certain categories of the disbelievers, and do not grieve over them, and lower your wings to the believers. This is a metaphoric statement which means be humble yourself to the believers. Surah Taha 20, chapter 20 of the Quran, verse 131. ولا فيها واو there is واو extra ولا تمدن عينيك إلى ما متعنا به أزواجا منهم زهرة الحياة الدنيا لنفتنهم فيه ورزق ربك خير وأبقى. And do not extend your eyes toward that by which we have given enjoyment to some categories of them. It's being but the splendor of worldly life by which we test them. And the provision of your Lord is better and more enduring. So every day, no matter what we give, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send two angels. ما من يوم يصبح فيه العباد إلا ملكان ينزلان يقول أحدهما اللهم أعطي منفقا خلفا ويقول الآخر اللهم أعطي ممسكا تلفا. حديث متفق عليه بين البخاري ومسلم. Every day, two angels descend every morning and one says, Oh Allah, give him who spends something in the place of what he spends. The other one will say, Oh Allah, give destruction to him who withholds. Now, Ibn Qayyim's index is over. Now I have two points to add to that. Al-ihsanu ila nafs. To be generous toward ourselves. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a good hadith, حديث مطرف عن أبيه قال أتيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو يقرأ الهاكم التكاثر سورة 102 من القرآن ثم قال يقول ابن آدم مالي مالي وهل لك من مالك يا ابن آدم إلا ما أكلت فأفنيت أو لبست فأبليت أو تصدقت فأمضيت أو فأبقيت في بعض الروايات وكما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. So to do charity for us by us, you know, fubu. For us, by us. Mutarif radiallahu anhu, he said his father came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam while he was reading chapter 1 or 2 of the Quran, Surah At-Takathur. About this diverts you. He said, the son of Adam claims my wealth, my wealth. And he, the Holy Prophet said, O son of Adam, is there anything as your belonging except that which you consumed, which you utilized, or which you wore and then it was worn out, or you gave as a charity and sent it forward. Whatever we give forward, we're gonna see it, we're gonna meet it. Whatever we leave behind is not ours. Famous hadith of that is the story of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the sheep and the shoulder. حديث عائشة رضي الله عنها قالت ذبحنا شاة فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ما بقي منها فقالت وفقلت عائشة رضي الله عنها بقي كلها غير كتفها انفقوها كلها إلا كتفها فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بقيت كلها إلا كتفها فالأجر هناك بما أنفق وما بقي إن شاء الله فيه خير لكن وجه الشاهد هنا أن ما ينفقه الإنسان هو الذي يبقى وما تنفقوا من شيء يوفى إليكم وما تنفقون إلا ابتغاء وجه الله وما تنفقوا من خير يوفى إليكم. So the messenger of Allah had slaughtered a sheep and distributed major portions of its meat. Then he asked Aisha, is there anything left? She replied, nothing except the shoulder. So they spent all of it except the shoulder. Look at the equation here. They spent all of it except the shoulder. That's what they have. So Prophet ﷺ said, all of it is left for the reward, except its shoulder. It is fine to keep, to use some things, but whatever the point here, whatever we spend, will be saved for us on the Day of Judgment. And also, Iftar al-Sa'im. And today, inshallah, in the new masjid, they have Iftar al-Sa'im today and tomorrow. Tomorrow here, inshallah, on Sunday, we'll have a potluck Iftar. Hadith Zayd ibn Khalid al-Juhani, من فطر صائما كان له مثل أجري غير أن ذلك لا ينقص من أجورهم شيئا. Whoever gives food to a fasting person will get the same reward of that fasting person or persons as a plural without diminishing or taking any of their rewards. إطعام الطعام وسقي الماء. Today, Friday, the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is to recite two sections of the Quran, 32 and 76. In Surah 76, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about feeding three types of people. وَيُطْعِمُونَ الطَّعَامَ عَلَى حُبِّهِ مِسْكِينًا وَيَتِيمًا وَأَسِيرًا. A needy, an orphaned, a prisoner, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's verse refers to Ali radiallahu anhu and Fatima, his beloved wife, the daughter of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But the point here, we should give food. يعني هذا الحديث good حديث حديث صحيح. أفضل الصدقة سقي الماء. The best of charity is to give water. Now it's summer. It's hot. Many places they don't have potable water. I mean, forget about Flint. This is just like, you know, small example here in this country. But many other people around the world, they don't have even water. It's point here, we should give that for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, now we're coming to some spending on family in 1 minute or so. This is inshallah ta'ala, last 2 points here. To be generous, to spend on the family. Sahih Muslim, there are 4 types of spending, 4 accounts. The best among them is that we spend on our family. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه حديث number 995 of Sahih Muslim قال دينار أنفقته في سبيل الله ودينار أنفقته في رقبة ودينار تصدقت به على مسكين أعظمها أجرا الذي أنفقت على أهلك. One of the dinar, this just replaces with the dollar, the buck. One of the dinar, the meaning of the hadith, you spend as a contribution in Allah's path or to set free a slave or as a charity given to a needy or to support your family, the one yielding the greatest reward is that which you spend on your family. So we should be generous on our families even more in this month. Even more in this month for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Surah 59, Surah Al-Hashr, the exile. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned a great example of the people of Medina and Ansar. Even though they are in a dire need, they prefer others. That's called al-Itha. Allah SWT said, وَيُؤْذِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ. That's chapter 59, verse 9. وَيُؤْذِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصَةً وَهِيَ شِدَّةُ الْإِحْتِيَاجِ. And they prefer muhajirin, the immigrants, above themselves, even though they are in privation. And last verse, inshallah, someone would say, okay, I don't have anything to do. I cannot do this, I cannot do that. What we should do? 2 things. One of them, to abstain from evil, as I'm going to explain. The second one, to have good intention. So someone who has nothing, who's broke, doesn't have $5, doesn't have $2, doesn't have a penny, and he loves to do this, all of this or most of it. The first one, remember that in Surah Talaq, divorce, may Allah save all of us from that. Chapter 65, verse 7. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لِيُنْفِقْ ذُو سَعَةٍ مِّن سَعَةٍ وَمَنْ قُدْرَ أَيْضُيِّقَ وَمَنْ قُدْرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْقُ فَلْيُنْفِقْ مِمَّا آتَاهُ اللَّهِ لَا يُكَلِّفُ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِلَّا وُسْعَهَا. Let a man of wealth spend from his wealth. And he whose provision is restricted, let him spend from what Allah has given him. Organs, limbs, remembrance, helping others. Doesn't have to be money. Allah does not charge a soul except according to what he has given it. So one day Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَفَرَأَيْتَ إِنْ ضَعَفْتُ أَفَرَأَيْتَ some narrations, إِنْ لَمْ أَجِدْ مَا أَتَصَدَّقُ بِهِ قَالَ لَهُ تُمْسِكُ عَنِ الشَّرِّ فَذَلِكَ صَدَقَةٌ مِّنْكَ عَلَى نَفْسِكَ. تُمْسِكُ عَنِ الشَّرِّ, لا تؤذي الناس, لا تسرق, لا تقتل, لا تغتب أحدا, لا تسعى في إذاء أحد. He said, O Prophet of Allah, what do you think that I should do if I'm too weak? I'm not able to spend for the sake of Allah. I'm broke. I don't have any money. He said, spare people your evil. Don't backbite. Don't slander. Don't kill. Don't cheat. Don't look at someone like this. Don't, you know, frown in his face. That is a charity which you bestow on yourself for us, by us. There is also a hadith known as the hadith إِنَّمَا الدُّنْيَا لِأَرْبَعَةِ نَفَرٍ. Dunya is only for 4 categories of people. 2 are good, may Allah make us among them. One of them has everything. He spends it for the sake of Allah. The second one, he said, oh Allah, I don't have a penny. But if I have money, I will spend like this generous person. They are same and equal in reward. And the opposite is same. Is it true? Someone who has a lot of money, he spends it in haram. The other one, prohibited things. The other one said, oh God, I don't have anything. But if I have it, I will go to Vegas. They are in the same category of bad rewards. So this is a month of generosity. There are plenty of actions that starts with remembrance of Allah, reading the Quran, tasbih, guiding people, helping them, advising them, helping our families, and forgiving people, you know, ignoring bad things that should be said about us, gossip. So we can do a lot of it And there is no excuse, at least if we cannot do any things of this, we should abstain from evils. Don't harm other peoples. And I will conclude with dua, so please say Ameen. اللهم لك الحمد حتى ترضى ولك الحمد إذا رضيت ولك الحمد بعد الرضا اللهم صل على محمد في الأولين وصل عليه في الآخرين وصل عليه في كل وقت وحين اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا أجمعين اللهم لك الحمد على أن بلغتنا رمضان اللهم كما بلغتنا رمضان فوفقنا لصيامه وقيامه وتقبل ذلك منا واجعله صالحا ولوجهك خالصا ولا تجعل فيه لغيرك شيئا اللهم أعتق رقابنا من النار في رمضان وأعتق رقاب آبائنا وأمهاتنا وأزواجنا وإخواننا وأبنائنا ومشايخنا اللهم أعتق رقاب جميع المسلمين واغفر لجميع المسلمين واهد جميع المسلمين واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم اشفنا واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وعافنا من كل بلاء يا رب العالمين اللهم يا رب ارفع الظلم عن المغلومين في كل مكان وأهلك الظالمين في كل مكان اللهم أهلك الظالمين يا رب العالمين رد كيدهم في نحورهم واجعل تدميرهم في تدبيرهم واجعل دائرة السوء عليهم يا رب العالمين اللهم أرنا فيهم يوما كيوم عاد وثمود اللهم خذهم أخذ عزيز مقتدر ربنا اطمس على أموالهم واشدد على قلوبهم اللهم أهلك حرثهم وأغرق نسلهم يا رب العالمين فرج يا رب عن اللاجئين والمهجرين والمحاصرين اللهم يا رب أنزل لهم من بركات السماء وأخرج لهم من بركات الأرض اللهم بارك لهم فيما رزقتهم وقهم عذاب النار اللهم انصرهم على من ظلمهم وهجرهم ودمر بيوتهم فرج يا رب عن المسجونين في سجون الطغاة وعجل بفرجهم ونصرهم يا رب العالمين ومكن لهم في الأرض واخلهم بخير في أهلهم وأموالهم واحفظ عليهم دينهم وأعراضهم يا رب العالمين اللهم أسألناك فأعطنا اللهم خزائنك ملأ نسألك من فضلك العظيم يا ذا الفضل العظيم قلت وقولك الحق المبين واسأل الله من فضله اللهم إنا نسألك من فضلك نسألك يا رب صحة لا تنسينا وغنى لا يطغينا ورفقة لا تلهينا نعوذ بك يا رب من جهد البلاء ودرك الشقاء وسوء القضاء وشماتة الأعداء وعضال الداء وخيبة الرجاء اللهم اشفنا واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من تحول عافيتك وفجاءة نقمتك وجميع سخطك يا رب العالمين اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الهم والحزن ونعوذ بك من العجز والكسل ونعوذ بك من الجبن والبخل ونعوذ بك من ضلع الدين وقهر الرجال ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم اغفر لموتى المسلمين واختم بالصالحات أعمالنا وبالسعادة آجالنا وتوفنا وأنت راض عنا وصل اللهم وسلم على سيدنا محمد وآله وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين وأقم الصلاة. الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
حقا لا إله إلا الله استقيموا لا تختلفوا فتختلف قلوبكم